Don, thank you so much for joining us today. The news you just announced, Avalon Advanced Materials with your partner, Cheetah Resources, for the development of the Nechalacho Rare Earths Project has the industry all abuzz. Can you tell us all about it, please?
Sure. So we're delighted to have a like-minded partner like Cheetah partner with us on the Nechalacho Project. They were actually interested when they saw our news release back in October, where we talked a little bit about having some ideas around how we could take advantage of some of the near-surface bastnaesite-rich rare earth resources at Nechalacho in the T-zone and another zone called the Tardiff Zone, and look at how they might be developed at a relatively small scale to produce a bastnaesite concentrate to recover neodymium-praseodymium from. And we also were starting to look at how we could use simple new ore sorting technology to make that concentrate. They saw that news release and contacted me afterwards and said, "That's a really good idea. We've been thinking of doing the same thing on another project we have. Why don't we talk about getting together on it?" And I said, sure. And the conversation started there and resulted in the arrangement we announced last week.
Well, I'm delighted to hear this news. I sent you a quick congratulations and would like to clarify to the Investor Intel audience that the target here are the magnet metals. Is that correct?
That's where the best opportunity is right now, Tracy, as you and your listeners would well know. The demand for high-strength permanent magnets using neodymium, praseodymium, dysprosium has not diminished since the days of the rare earth bubble. In fact, it's increasing now with the demand being created by electric vehicles and those electric motors requiring high-strength permanent magnets made with neodymium. And that supply chain never really did get created outside of China to any meaningful extent. So we're starting to see the same circumstances arise again that arose in 2009-10 with the world realizing that the supply sources for these critical elements are indeed limited. So the opportunity is there, I think, to start to look at how that supply can be brought to market. And I think we've got to start looking at new creative models on how to do that in more efficient ways using new technology.
Well, Don, I couldn't agree with you more and your assessment on what's happening in the market right now with rare earths. So can you tell us a little bit more about how this partnership with Cheetah may actually work?
Yeah, so we looked at different variants on the model there, and they were really just most interested in the T-zone and the opportunity that that provided and the Tardiff zone. So we decided just to keep it simple and kind of carve off a piece of the entire asset we have there for them to take ownership of and move forward on that model with us still helping them with the overall project management, and then see if we can get something going there with them. We will still retain a royalty interest in the whole property. And once it gets into production, we establish some infrastructure there, then we see great potential to ultimately scale the operation up, because as we all know, the demand for rare earths is going to continue to grow, and start to look at the other resources on the property, including the basal zone, as future development opportunities as the market grows and the opportunity to increase production surfaces.
Well, Don, thank you so much for updating us on this most recent partnership. As always, it's a pleasure to speak to you.
Thank you.